in the year 203 after Hijra, Ma'mun al-Abbasi does something which is uncommon among most of the Khulafas of Bani Umayyah and al-Abbas. Most of the Abbasis and the Umayyads do not personally feed poison to the Imams. They would send people. Like, for example, you know, the Harun al-Rashid, he ordered the Sindi ibn Shahik to give the poison to the Imam. Like, so they would order, but they would not physically, personally. Ma'mun personally, it is said, took the poison and started to thread it into the grapes and the pomegranates. So he personally poisoned the food. He invited Imam al-Ridha alayhi salam, and he told Imam al-Ridha, here, join me for eating this food. Imam al-Ridha knew of the plan, and he knew what was happening. But this is the command of Allah, Amr Allah. When Allah says to the Imams that it is time for you to leave this dunya, the Imam says, yes, Ya Rab. They do taslim to Allah. But it is the consequence of these tyrants, these oppressive rulers. So they fed them the poison. La'natullahi alayhim ajma'in. Those people who killed our Imams, alayhim as-salam. He feeds the poison to the Imam. Imam takes a few grapes, eats them. Ma'mun says, eat more, have more. He says, this is enough to execute your plan. That's it. And indeed, Imam al-Ridha alayhi salam gets up with a companion of his by the name of Abu Salt al-Hirawi. When he comes out of the palace of Ma'mun, Imam says, Ya Abu Salt, he's fed me the poison. He poisoned me. I'm not going to make it. So he goes to the house. He starts feeling the pain of the poison. It starts to overtake him. But look at the compassion of Imam. One of the titles of Imam al-Ridha is al-Imam al-Ra'uf. Compassionate. He was dying, basically. He was in pain of the poison. He looks at his servants and his maids, and he tells them, have you people eaten? The people said, Ya Ibn Rasulullah, you are in such a state, you're dying, and you want us to eat. We've lost our appetite. Imam al-Ridha, in that state, gets up. He says, no, bring the dinner table. Bring the food, I will eat with you. And so they bring the table. He says, make two tables, one for the ladies, one for the men. Imam does not sit co-ed among with non-mahrams. No, he does not do this. Let us learn the hijab and the modesty of Ahlul Bayt. Table for the women, table for the men. He sits with the maids, with the servants, with his own servants, with the abid. And he starts to eat. And he makes them eat. He makes sure they all fed, they're all eaten well. And then he says, okay, now lift the table. Look at the Imam al-Ra'uf. He takes care even during his pain, his difficulty. We say, Ya Ibn Rasulullah, have mercy on us also when we are in the qabr, when we are in the grave. Then he goes into his room with Abu Salt al-Hirawi. He says, Ya Abu Salt, lock the doors. Don't allow anyone to enter. I am about to meet my Lord. He's gharib al-ghuraba, the stranger alone in Khurasan. He lies on his bed, feeling the pain of the poison overtaking his strength and his powers slowly, slowly. Abu Salt al-Hirawi says, as I was standing next to the Imam crying, all of the sudden I see a young boy, 7 or 8 years of age. That was the age of this child came. All of the sudden he entered into this room. I looked at this child. I told him, where did you come from? The Imam gave me instructions to lock the doors. He is not allowed anyone to enter. How did you get in here? He said, Ya Abu Salt, the one who brought me from Medina to here is the one who allowed me to enter into this chamber of my father. I am Muhammad ibn Ali al-Jawayad. I came to see my father, Imam al-Ridha, in his final moments. This was the age of Imam al-Jawad, about 7 or 8 years of age. He came next to his father. He hugged his father, Imam al-Ridha. When Imam al-Ridha saw his son, he felt some ease. He hugged him. He started giving him the final will of the imama, the wasaya. And then Imam al-Ridha alayhi salam stretches his arms and his feet and says, Bismillah wa billah wa ala millati jaddi Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alihi. وفاضت روحه الطاهرة إلى السماء. And his soul departed his body. Imam al-Jawad started crying, أيوا أبتا, أيوا عليا, أيوا مظلوما, أيوا غريبا. then Ma'mun, of course, ordered that the burial be taken because this is a state funeral. But it is said that Imam al-Jawad was doing everything. One of the companions says, I saw Imam al-Jawad doing the ghusl, doing the kafan, praying the salat, but people are not seeing. People do not see the Imam salamullahi alayh. And then part of the musiba of Imam al-Ridha, Ma'mun orders that Imam al-Ridha be buried right next to his father, Harun al-Rashid. So he buried next to each other. I say, Ya Imam al-Ridha, when you were leaving this dunya, your son Imam al-Jawad came to take care of you. He did your ghusl, your kafan, your salat, and he took care of your funeral and burial. But who was there for Abi Abdullah al-Hussein, salamullahi alayhi? 3 days he remained on the plains of Karbala. Zainab was crying, Ya Jadda, Ya Rasul Allah, Hada Husaynuka fil Ara, Maslub al Imamati wal Rida. Imam al-Sajjad came after 3 days to bury Imam al-Hussein alayhi salam. As he put him down in his grave, he heard a voice coming from the throat of Imam al-Hussein saying, Bunay Ali, wasid radi'i ala sadri, put my baby on my chest. Ya Imam al-Ridha, your women, your children were taken care of by Imam al-Jawad alayhi salam, but who was there for Zainab, Sukayna, Ruqayya? They were being beaten by the enemies of Allah. Ayah, inna lillah wa inna ilayhi raji'un wa sayalamu alladhina zalamu ayya munqalabin yanqalibun wal aqibatu lil muttaqin.